picked the wrong week and quit sniffing glue.
Well, welcome back, everybody. What a week it's been. It's Friday. Tell you how my week's going. It's Friday, and I'm recording something to post today. I suppose everybody wants to know how my Wonderfest went. Well, you might or you might not. That's egotistical to assume that everybody wants to know how Lou's Wonderfest went. But I saw so many other great videos out there. I guess I better put my two cents in. As I said, I believe I said a week or so ago, I wasn't going to try to do dealer room and contest room videos because there are so many other better people at that than me. As a matter of fact, Wayne has stepped up to the plate and he did a very good video on both halves of that. So I highly recommend you check out World of Wayne's contest room and dealer room videos if you want to see the nuts and bolts of it. I'll give you my impressions of the show. Now to quote that line from Airplane 2, I'm a doctor, I don't do impressions. How did you do? Well, I did, but okay, I got gold on Talos, I got a silver on Maria, and I got a bronze on the Sandcrawler. And the other three things that I took, the Concept Shuttle, the Oblivion Drone, and Vampirella, they got merits. Judging is something you can never second guess. You can always try to figure out what they're thinking. You'll never get it right. I've tried to put it past me. The ranking of these things brings out my competitive side, and I don't like my competitive side. So I'm just trying to put that to the side and say, yay, I'm happy I got what I did, and we will tackle this thing again next year. And then the second half of that is, well, what did you bring home? Well, let me show you what I brought home. There are some got-to-haves every year. When I go, first of all, I'm in my Wonderfest, this is the crew t-shirt, and I'll be happy to tell you that I started the line for the crew t-shirt. They didn't go on sale until Saturday at noon, and 20 minutes till noon, I stood in front of the booth and proudly proclaimed to all that would hear that the line started behind me. Because I was not going to miss out on it again this year. I think I missed out on them last year because I was too late to the party. So this year I made sure. And by the time they opened it up for sales, there was quite a line behind me. So I did get my John Eves designed last 40 years of Last Starfighter t-shirt. So I always get my regular Wonderfest shirt. I got the staff shirt. I always go to the Blackheart booth, George Stevenson Blackheart booth, because for the last few years he's had this collection of minibus of Star Trek figures, and I wanted to get this year's Star Trek figures, and I'll bring the camera down to the table. So there was that I needed to take care of. There was another tribute resin kit that I wanted to make sure that I got, because I think last year it was only there as a prototype. I don't think they had any production kits there. So I made sure I got one of those. And there was something else I'd seen online that I wanted to make sure I picked up. So we'll get down to the table here and look at these. But the last of them has quite a story of its own. And we'll get to that when I tell you. But first, yes, here's my gold knee, what I call the knee knocker. It's heavy. That was for Talos, and you know, you can kick yourself, you can try to second guess. Like I said, you take a model that you spent 3 or 4 weeks on and you're sweating over every detail, and it gets a passing notice and a merit, and then you could take something like Talos, which for me was an afternoon build. You know, you put it together, you paint it with a bronze undercoat, and then you put a blue wash on it, it's done, and you add a couple little details to it, and it gets a gold. So it's not the question of how much time you put into it, it's strictly results. I'm glad that Maria got a silver. I'm glad she got some notice. I was hoping that all that hard work would have paid off or something. Got a very nice compliment on it from John Eves, so that alone. The reason you go to Wonderfest is to meet and reacquaint yourself and re-meet all of the great people that you see there from year to year. And I have to tell you that I spent more time this year handing out stickers and shaking hands, and that's probably where I got this cold from. But I spent more time away from my central gang. You know, it's like high school. You go to your little cliques of the people that you know every year, and I made a conscious effort this year to try to do more spread out stuff and more talking to other people. I ran into so many people this year who this was their first show, an astounding number, and that's good. That says good things, that it was their first show, and I know they'll be back. The hotel went through some renovations this year. I still can't recommend the restaurant, folks. Wonderfest is great if you bring your own food, or don't mind leaving the premises to get it, because what they've got under their roof is not worth writing home about. Let's see. Getting the room was an interesting story. I had three separate reservations because when I tried to do it online, I could get Friday, and then I could get Saturday and Sunday, and then I can get Monday. I couldn't get them all in a four and a block. So the lesson there is call them up on the line, on the reservation line. Don't try to do it over the computer. Do it early, but if you can talk to the hotel in person, that's the best way to go. Let's see what else. Oh, the renovations of the carpeting. You've seen videos of the Escher carpeting. Not good if you are slightly hungover and you're trying to walk a straight line down that hallway. Oh boy, that messes with your head. The room they stuck me in, I referred to as the Tatooine room. It was, if there's a bright center to the hotel, I was in the room it was furthest from. I'm not my centralized room that I was used to, which added a lot of time to the taking entries down and getting them into the contest and out. That went a lot easier this year because of the loophole of if you have a dealer badge, you can get in at 8 a.m. You can get in before 8 a.m. because I went down around 7. And you could get in before 8 to start putting your things into the contest on Saturday if you were a dealer badge. So that helped a lot. And also it helped to not need electricity except for one. Maria was the only thing that plugged into the wall. The rest of them I could run on batteries so they could be placed easier anywhere else, which helps. Because if you're trying to get, if your model has power and it depends on power, then you can have an issue because you're running out of space and there's only so many plugs there and everybody else's is running on power. I noticed a lot of the kits were bigger this year. A lot of the entries were bigger, took up more space, were more elaborate, however you want to describe it. They were bigger. It's odd what you see from year to year. There were a lot of Marias there this year. There were a lot of Rotwangs there this year. There was not a single refit. 350 refit. There were 1,000 scale refits, and there were 1,000 scale original series Enterprises, but there was not a single 350 refit. I saw one 350 NX 01, and that was it. So it's interesting how tastes come and go. I saw, frankly, and this might be an unpopular opinion, I saw a lot of things there that I don't think belonged in a Wonderfest show. Were very wonderfully well-made models, but were not subjects that were appropriate. They were military vehicles. It's like, go to an IPMS show. You got your own show for that. I saw some beautifully elaborate sets, TV sets, from comedies. Again, if you know which one I'm talking about, you know. It's nice. It's beautiful. It's well-made. It's not sci-fi. It's not horror. It's not fantasy. What's it doing at a Wonderfest show? That's the only thing I'm going to say about that. I saw a lot of things that I thought were in the wrong categories. Just because a character is on a vehicle doesn't necessarily make it a vehicle entry. It should have been over in the superhero category with the other iterations of that character. This is not the example, but if you put Batman on a bat cycle, it's not a vehicle. It shouldn't be a vehicle entry. It should be a superhero entry. It's just confusing that way. By and large, Fine Scale Models did want to take a picture of the concept shuttle, so at least I got that. If it got nothing else, at least it got some attention from Fine Scale Modeler. The dealer room was wonderful. It was packed. It was great. There was all kinds of activity. People seemed to be spending money right and left and center. Every vendor that I talked to said they were up from last year. It was great. There was no big gotta have release this year, though. Nothing from your Mobius or your Round 2 or from your Revell. There was no big commercial release. There was a lot of great stuff there, which I really think was good because it cleared the pocketbook and the runway for all these other great independent sellers who had their own kits. And it's like, well, if I've spent $100 on a space station, I don't have that $100 to spend on a Frankenstein kit. So I think it did. Anybody who came with a wad of cash had no trouble making that wad disappear because there were umpteen opportunities to sell. And I think it went really well. There was never a time that I was in the dealer room that it was particularly dead. It was always full of people. I've got no idea about the attendance figure. They don't normally release or advertise their attendance figures, but I know that there was over 1,000 entries in the contest. That's healthy. Although, like me, I know a lot of people who brought a lot last year that cut back the number that they brought. So maybe there are just more people entering, more different people, and people not entering as many as they did. So let me show you what I came home with. And we'll go from there. Okay, we'll start with the Blackheart kits, the Trek kits. We have the Romulan Commander. We have Baylock, the Baylock puppet. We have Nurse Chapel, and then we have the Salt Vampire, Nancy. Her name was McGill. She called herself Lil, but everyone knew her as Nancy. So these will fill in the... I swear to you, I'm going to get started on these. I've got quite a collection of them, and I haven't painted any of them yet, so... We may just start doing masses of Trek bus. This is the Jim Henson tribute. I haven't even unpacked this yet because the parts are so big that I didn't want to get them out until I'm ready to start on it. But it looks, let's hear the side of the box. I love the packaging on this. That's what it looks like. It's a bust from the waist up of Jim Henson with Kermit on his hand. And the rods going out to Kermit's arms. But that I'm looking forward to doing. I don't know if that Kermit is the right proportion or the right scale to flock or not. Probably not. I don't think I'll be able to simulate the felt. I might have to paint that. It could already have a pattern in the resin. I haven't looked at it. So that's something I'm looking forward to working on this year. These little guys, let me see if I can get the box and show it. They're called the Plutonium Crew. It's from Heavy Metal. It's from one of my favorite segments in Heavy Metal. It's the Great Nyborg, man. It's the two drivers and the John Candy space robot. I have heard that maybe if this sold well, that there would be a second set that would include the Redheaded Secretary and maybe some other characters from that same segment, but it depends, I guess, on the sale. These are 3D printed. These are resin cast. This is resin cast, but these pieces are 3D printed and very well printed. They are. You could even hide a little bit of your stash in there if you wanted to. That would make a perfect hiding place. But we got those three guys. I picked up a tool because I like a tool. This is a micro polishing pen. We're going to see how well that goes. It's lower speed than a Dremel, but made for finer work. So Phil swears by them. I'm going to give them a try. I was actually stopped in the hall and given a model. Sometimes that happens. Very nice people come up to me and they say, Lou, would you please build this on your channel? And I will. And this is the case for Joshua. Joshua Lachance. He stopped me in the hall and gave me this USS Titan model. It's a resin kit, but it's fully it's a very nice resin kit, but it's solid. There will be no lights put into this, but I will build it up and put the decals on it, and we will have fun with that in the coming months. And that brings us to the last kit. Well, the second to last kit, because I say the last kit was from my friend Dave over at Model Works. He's here locally with me in North Carolina. So he had a booth set up, and he had a beautiful kit, an absolutely beautiful kit at his table of the Metaluna Martian and a Space Gal. And what I did was this, I didn't want to take a sale away from him at Wonderfest and leave him with one less product there, because I could get one from him anytime. So what I'm going to do is at our next model meeting, I'll be picking one up from him. But he was debuting it at Wonderfest, and it stands about 18 inches tall altogether. Again, I will show you that when I get it, but I didn't want to take one away from his table while he was, going to be selling them there. So once I get that, I'll certainly put it on the video. And the last one I have here is what they called the Slutty Sandy. Now, the Slutty Sandy became a bit of a running joke. This was the Sunday Night Banquet prize. During the Sunday Night Banquet, they have announcements from Dave Hodge, from the showrunner, makes some announcements about how well the show went and that sort of thing. And he also, there's a little bit of dinner theater, which I have to say, this was the first time in maybe the last 5 years that I sat through the entire dinner show. It was good. It has not been as good in the past. That's all I'll say. This year's was good. They did Jaws in 30 minutes or less. It was funny. It was brisk. It said what it wanted to say, and then it was over. It was, like I said, it was a refreshing change from some of their other dinner shows. But they had, excuse me, they had about a dozen. Nah, maybe not that many. They had multiple copies of this resin kit. And it's this one right here. I'll show you. It's the resin kit. You recognize this. This is Olivia Newton-John as Sandy from the last scene in Grease. The Tell Me About It stud. The part of the movie that is the most problematic, in a movie full of things that are mixed messages. The moral of the story is you should turn yourself into a leather-wearing, loose-moraled whatever to keep your man is not exactly the lesson you should be teaching your small children. But they had this model, and they were giving it away as part of the door prize. You put your, when you bought your ticket, you put your name in a door prize. And the guy, when he brought them out, he says, we have about a dozen of these, which tells you how well it sold this year at the show. So they were giving them away for the door prize, and they called them the Slutty Sandys. And she's not particularly slutty. She's a little bit loose, but I wouldn't necessarily call her slutty. But that became the gag. Everybody wanted to get the Slutty Sandy. So it became like an Oscar. Everybody was making Slutty Sandy speeches. So, careful, Slutty Sandy. She's let's see, the hand comes off there. There we go. But it's a weird capture on the expression. The sculpt has just got, she's got the weirdest expression on her face. So this was a case where I didn't win a Slutty Sandy, but after they had finished drawing them all, a fine gentleman came over and said, would you like my Slutty Sandy, because resin kits aren't for everybody. This guy's name was Robert Seitz, and he asked me, he said, would you like to build this? And I said, yes, Robert, I would love to build your Slutty Sandy. So at some point that will also be built. But it's strange that outside of the one Titan ship, that everything I have got brought back this year was a figure. I don't consider myself a figure builder. I'm more of a ship builder. I like building ships, but yet I've got all these figures. And ironically, it is the figures that I seem to do the best with in the competition. So maybe the modeling gods are trying to tell me something. So Sunday, we pack up all, and thank you to Phil and to Keith. Oh, I was so happy. This reminds me. I was so happy for Keith Tomlinson, my friend over at Cosmic Scale Models. He brought a small amount of product, and he was going to sell it out of his room. He runs Cosmic Scale Models over in the UK. Now, for him to bring any amount of product over to the United States in a suitcase, that's a feat. That's a feat by itself. But he brought some stuff over. It very quickly sold. He had a few things left. One of the showrunners said, said to him, Keith, why don't you get a table? There was a couple of vendors that had never showed up, so there was an empty vendor table. Keith said, okay, brought his stuff out, and the rest of it sold. And that more or less cemented the fact that Keith will be there next year with a full inventory of things for sale. And I know he's going to do well. His stuff fits in there like a glove. So I was happy to see that. That gets me back to... that was Sunday. Oh, Keith and Phil and Wayne saved my bacon. They all helped me pull my stuff out of the contest room, and we packed it in the car and got it ready to go. And then Sunday night we had the banquet where I had to move a table for them because there were our table. Again, it's like high school at the cool kids at the lunch tables. They're all set up and the tables are only so big. And if you want to have 20 people at your table and your table only seats 10, you have to grab another table and bring it over. So I hate to say it, but I had to grab a table for Wayne and for Keith and for Phil to bring them over to where the rest of us cool kids were sitting. So we had the banquet. And that just meant Monday morning driving out. And driving back, not a problem in the world. Blue skies, light traffic, tedious is about all I can say. There was nothing. A little bit of traffic as we got closer to Raleigh, but that's about it. It was a beautiful trip. You know, when I am by myself in the car, I've got my tunes on and I'm singing at the top of my lungs, and you don't want to be anywhere near that. But it makes the throat dry, and all the talking that I did and meeting people and shaking hands this weekend, I was just flat wore out. I woke up Tuesday hacking and coughing, and I felt as bad as I did when I was in England. And I joked that I think Phil gave me something. He's a carrier. I don't trust him. He's a carrier. And that's my week that was. But I came back here and I took care of some got the models all put back up. Got the clothes in the laundry, all that kind of stuff. I got the got the models put up. There was a couple orders that came in that while I was gone. There was a promise I broke to somebody that I needed to make good on. I promised I would take him a template set and meet him at Wonderfest and hand it to him. And I forgot, and that's on me. So I quickly plotted that and got it into the mail so that he could get it as quick as possible. But that's my week. Now, next week, I have got to get working on that shark. Wayne and Phil are done with theirs. They were showing pictures of theirs to each other. I went like all this so that I wouldn't have to be influenced by it. But they were teasing me over the fact that I hadn't even finished mine. I hadn't really started it yet. So I've got to get on the shark, and also talked to Canadian Starship Builder about the Enterprise D, the big 650D. So we've all got that. We've got those irons in the fire. Boy, like I said, the week was a blur, and it's hard to believe it's a week ago already that I was driving up there. I think I've talked long enough. Sorry about the lack of pictures, but like I said, there are folks out there that have much better videos of that than me. So until next week, we'll be back to our regularly scheduled shows. Y'all be good. Be good to each other. Be safe. Be smart. Be back next week.